A time that you can put it to, maybe it's 7:30 or it's about 11 minutes to 8 a.m. or it's this particular day. Day in, day out, you should be having conversations about who you are and how you are limitless. Did you even know that? Because sometimes it's the thoughts in your head, it's the people you surround yourself with, it's also simply what you listen to. And thank God, also what you watch. So right now on Morning at NTV, if you're watching from wherever you are, tell someone to also pull a chair. Or maybe turn into and tune into Morning at NTV on NTV, because right now we get into the conversation of how you can become limitless if you aren't already, or how you can discover that you are limitless. Now I'm joined by a news anchor, a radio personality, and a content creator. And I'm trying to keep it very professional. Very, very professional. Mrs. Flavia Tumusime Kabura.
Hello.
Welcome to Morning at NTV.
Thank you.
You're now on the other side.
Yes. I'm very okay with it. I'm very okay with being on the other side.
Okay. Now, yes. Being on the other side, you are limitless.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone should be limitless at this point in time.
Not really. Mm-hmm. It's a journey. It takes time. And sometimes it's like layers. You get to a sudden limitless and you're like, I've arrived. And then you have to discover certain things about yourself in life, and then you have to grow at the next phase, which is why someone who's 60 years old today will advise a 20-year-old differently, and a 40-year-old will advise them differently, because you're always learning.
Yes.
You're always learning. That's how life is.
They say life is a journey.
Oh, yes.
Of learning.
Oh, yes.
So your journey of becoming limitless, mm-hmm. where did it start, and where is it now?
Well, first of all, I think just to define being limitless, because when I said, oh, I have a limitless event, they said, did you just pull that word? You're looking for cool words, and you decided limitless? No. I wanted to get to a point where I can define what it means to shatter all the barriers that are given to you by family when they're raising you, the society that you live in, your workmates that you work with, and then, of course, eventually yourself. You know, the things you tell yourself you can't do because, you know, those are not for me. Those are things for people who are too educated or too learned or too traveled. Those are limits, you understand? So before you know it, you're 31 like me and you've told yourself 1,000 things. And so that's 1,000 things you cannot achieve. And so when you start to learn that I can control my life, I can take charge, I can do certain things for myself, that's being limitless. So for me, I feel like I have finally learned how to let go.
Very important thing. Very, very important thing.
You know when you decide that I'm good at this, I like doing this, but it's not really for me. When you come to that decision of being free enough to let go of something, which has been, I think, my journey, especially my career, for the last maybe year or so, I used to tell myself, I don't want to get married because I'll get married and then give up my career, which I've worked so hard for. And then I realized, no, it's just the next phase, you know? You can actually excel in the next phase, or you can improve yourself for the next phase. And so I started to say, okay, it's okay, I can be limitless differently.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You know, so I can still come to work and still excel, except it won't be the same definition that it was when I was 25. Do you see what I mean? I probably won't go for the same opportunities, but I'm going for different opportunities.
That means you define, you start to define things
your
own way. Because clearly when you say, mm-hmm. I am not going to go by what either my mind was saying or what mm-hmm. people were saying, but I'm defining it for myself.
Yes.
But at what times do you define it mm-hmm. and not start to encroach on anyone else's limits or being their mm-hmm. own, being limitless?
I'm going to say you have to step on people's toes. But I think how I would define it, for example, for me in my career, I used to be up at 4 a.m. at any given point in my career and end the day wherever work ended.
Is where
okay, because for me, I was, imagine they tell you to start picking money. You know, people don't go like this.
No.
They spread out
and come in
as much as I can grab. So that used to be my life. Mm-hmm. Opportunities, even if it's somewhere in Kamwen, I will go. You understand? That used to be me because I hadn't figured out quality over quantity.
Mm-hmm.
And so now I still work. I still take opportunities, but I've defined myself. I've said, okay, for me, I will stand for women and youth. What's the story I want to tell them? How do I want to help them? Okay, so when you start to write that, you start to say there are 7 opportunities, but I can only take 4. You understand? So I can't work with you. I can't work with you. Not because you're terrible, but because at this point, Rita, you and I, we don't align mm-hmm. with my dream, you know? So, and you've got to get to a certain point in life to do such things.
Yes. And it takes discovery.
Yeah. And also you need to first make your money. I'm being honest, you know, because sometimes people tell you follow your dreams mm-hmm. and you have to pay bills. That's the truth. You're following your dreams, but you're thrown out of the house because you can't pay rent. Mm-hmm. And you. So I always tell people, there's a cushion. There's a place where you are before you can get to you know, your dreams. So if it is somebody saying that I'll be a janitor before I get to be a great accountant, it's okay. You're paying your bills for now. It's that cushion that will eventually help you get to your dreams.
But that also takes goals, having goals in mind, because as you mentioned, mm-hmm. I want to be this, but mm-hmm. I'm a janitor right now.
Yes.
So start to make your goals. And what goals have you had? And then also someone will say, do I have to make 10-year plan kind of goals? Does mm-hmm. it have to be something very short? How do you draw the line between a plan and a goal? Because mm-hmm. all that gets confusing.
Which is, I mean, for the Limitless event, because what we've done is set a Limitless card, and it will help people who come to the event to sort of plan, because not everybody's a planner. People don't really know how to plan their lives. They're like, I wake up, I'm alive, let's just go with it. Yeah. So we're going to help them figure out how to plan today, maybe in a month or in a week, and then eventually it will define the 10 years. You're supposed to work backwards, ideally. You're supposed to say in 5 years, I'd like to be the best TV presenter, and then work backwards. How will I get there? How will I fill in the pieces to get to the best TV presenter? Obviously, you can't be the next or best TV presenter when you're not on TV.
You must get on TV.
Yeah, so how, if you're not anywhere on TV, it's how do I get to be on TV? Okay, so there are 6 TV stations, or there's only one. Okay, get to it. And don't say, I know. Knocked on the door, they told me to go, and I also left. You understand what I mean?
Pushing.
Yeah, so you keep pushing. And also, I feel like people, when they're defining their goals, they define it one way. I'll use the TV presenter idea. I might want to be a great TV presenter, but today and now, the slots are filled. Today and now, they're filled. I have to learn about the TV, because TV isn't just you and I who are in front of the camera. Mm-hmm. There's somebody manning the camera. If they don't do it right, you and I won't be seen. Microphones are on so we can be heard. If somebody doesn't do it properly and professionally and well, we won't be heard. There's somebody who makes sure this lighting works a certain way. There's somebody who makes sure that we have a schedule to why you're here, what time it will end. You know, they manage that. There's a whole line of people who are working in television, and not just the two people here. So you need to say, okay, can I walk in as sound? Mm-hmm. Can I start my journey there? Okay, sound, I've improved, I've become the best. Now how do I get to producer level? And before you know it, by the time you get to your dream as a TV presenter, you have 8 skills that you've picked up along the way. And not say, because I wasn't given the role of a TV presenter, that's it, my dream is dead. So I think people have tunnel vision the wrong way. They say, me, I just wanted this.
It's not to be there. In front of
so
it.
Me, I have given up. And that's also a big limit, actually. Mm-hmm.
Now, when you talk about limits, there's failure to it. Mm-hmm. When you fail to achieve something, you've mentioned it, if you knock and they don't open until you go,
yes.
What do you do?
Yeah.
Because we can talk about how being limitless happens, and you can go ahead and mm-hmm. you can be limitless. But what happens when you fail along the way?
Mm-hmm.
Do you pick yourself up? Do you give up on the plan? What goes on there?
You cry sometimes.
Then after crying, what do you do?
You cry sometimes. I've listened to a sermon that said that everybody teaches you how to pray to get, and everybody teaches you how to celebrate. But yeah, we all know how to celebrate when something good happens in your life. Nobody teaches you what happens when it's a no. When God says, Rita, I don't want to give you that car. What happens then? How do you react? I think in being limitless is also not being afraid of the direction you're going, not being nice, if I can use that. Because you might be excited, for example, to be hired somewhere, right? And I think you and I personally have had this discussion. And you get there and you're saying, I'm great at what I do. And I'm in the right position. But everything else around it is not making it favorable, for example. The environment I'm in is not making it favorable. There are people who are working now, probably one of the biggest group of people I'm getting who are coming to the Limitless event, are people telling me, I want to quit my job. And I'm saying, what do you mean? I mean, there are no jobs. You should be
quitting.
And they're telling
leave?
You, no. My boss doesn't like me. They treat me a certain way. There are no logistics and resources for me to do my work. There's so many reasons someone is telling, I'm not fulfilled, is another reason people tell you they want to quit their jobs. And so it's they have the job. Someone else will look at them and be like, but you're lucky, you have that. But they're saying it's not a good environment to be in. There's so many things that are coming against me. And part of being limitless is saying that, you know what, the environment is not nice, but I am here. What do I want? I want to do this for like a year, gonna this and then walk away. So what can I do every single day to make it work for me? For example, I was sharing with someone this morning who said, I say, you know what, as long as I can come and do A, B, C, D, E, F, G, the rest of you are noisemakers. The rest of you are just talking.
Yeah.
And you can do that. You can walk in and say that, you know, for me, I'll come to work, whether my boss is making noise, whether they're not,
Me, I've come to do
me, I've come to do my, and I'm doing my job. Mm. I'm doing it because I think that every time I go above and beyond trying to be happy with people, trying to make everybody happy, trying to fit in with everybody, it takes you away from the focus. Mm. And then you end up being too hurt about the noise and not about your work. I always used to tell people, you cannot claim I hugged everybody at work, but you can claim I was professional. You can claim I did my job. And I tell people, outside, I try and hug everyone because they were making friends in my job. I'm trying to do my job right. Mm. So if you can claim I did my job right, don't add, but
I did my job.
I did my job right. Mm. So in being limitless as well is to accept it's not working and learn how to live around it and with it.
Well, when you talk about living in it and living around it, we have people that surround us.
Yes.
So when we talk about being limitless, who comes to, you have mentioned it, the breakfast, the limitless breakfast. Mm-hmm. Who steps into that space? Someone who feels everyone around me just seems to be saying the wrong things. Should I bring those people to the limitless breakfast? Should I just bring myself so that I can learn to shout out everyone and know it's about me and how I need to perform because I have my goals and my plan? Who comes to a limitless breakfast?
First of all, just to give a little background about why I did the limitless event. It's not come pay me money and no, I'm actually not even going to make a profit on this event because my big goal, like you said, everyone must have a goal, is to make a difference. I feel like I've done TV for 18 years. So, I mean, unless I'm waiting to make a difference in my 25th year, which is ridiculous, 18 years in the business is good enough.
Very good.
And 14 years in radio is good enough for me. I feel like I can have a story to tell. And I feel like the biggest thing that people do for me is walk up to me and start telling me a story. So I'm at an event and someone is on the side. So I was telling you, I find myself, I'm at a wedding, I'm here to enjoy, but we're in a conversation. And I said, not everybody is going to get to me. Not everybody is going to be able to ask me certain questions. So can I have certain events during the year? Can I have a vlog, which I have started? Can I be able to share my information, my story, what I know, how we can improve each other in a certain way? So the vlog was part one, and the limitless events and idea is part two. So the people I want to show up to the limitless event is a person who says, if you look at my life from outside, it's tick, 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 tick. But me, if you ask me, there are holes that honestly are draining me. I look perfect to everybody. I look like I have everything I need in life, but I'm breaking. Mm. And I can't tell that to people because they feel I'm not grateful for my life. That's the kind of woman I want to see at the Limitless event. I want to see the woman who says, me, I'm just going through life. I'm not sure if I'm about making money, if I'm about making friends, I'm just going through life. So I need purpose. I need to find my why. That's the woman I want to see at the Limitless event. I want to find the person who feels like I know how to do the work thing, just don't know how to do the life thing. Do you know what I mean? Mm. Like, I'm very good. Like, if it's work, I know.
Perfect.
I know deadlines, timings. I can write you a concept note and you're like, this girl is amazing. But then when it comes to like a boyfriend, a relationship, and not just personal, intimate relationships, even just friends, I don't know how to make them. Like, I don't know how to do that thing. And you want to be balanced, that's the woman I want to see at the Limitless event.
Okay. Yeah. Now, that woman that you mentioned is choosing herself first.
Yes.
And we're in an era where self-love has become something very, very important. Mm-hmm. Now, her saying, you know what, when she's done with this breakfast and she realizes, no, this job, it's not fulfilling. She went there with the idea and the notion that it was already not fulfilling.
Yes.
And Flavia has told her, you know, if you've already gotten into a particular room, you can now walk in and leave this other thing behind and now set plans. But where do you put yourself and the people around you and choose not to just have those two clash? Because they're happening to clash lately. Mm-hmm. Someone just shows up like, no, today it's self-love. I'm not going to work on Friday. You have a job to show up.
That's not self-love. Self-love is also being disciplined, okay, and doing the right thing. But I feel like you said, she came in knowing she's not satisfied. She doesn't want the job. All she needs is a nudge from Flavia to tell her, leave the job.
Bye.
I get it. But I think what Flavia would tell her is, before you leave the job, is there a plan? As I said, we all want to be limitless and be amazing and have these great things happening, but we have bills to pay. Limitless won't put fuel in the car. So I would advise such a person to don't put all your energy on this negative community or negative workspace. Put all your energy in the plan B. Do you see what I mean? So if I'm at my job, maybe as a TV presenter, and I'm not happy here, but not because I don't know what I'm doing, but because maybe of the environment, I would say to be limitless is to every single day dedicate an hour on my plan B. So I'm looking at you. You're not a nice person at work, but I'm like, hey, I know where I'm going. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah.
I know. For me, in 2 months, I know where I'm going. So it actually gives you inspiration to show up because you have a time frame to your plan B, which you're putting so much energy on. But some people, I think, are too broken to work on plan B.
So healing, when you mentioned broken,
yes.
Before you go ahead to work on plan B, we also, the healing bit of things.
Mm-hmm.
How do you heal? Where do you choose to get your source of healing?
Mm-hmm.
And have you been broken?
Yeah.
And if you were, how did you heal? Because, you know, you have mentioned
Rita.
That you're using your story
yes.
to be able to help mm-hmm. another lady out mm-hmm. there. So have you been broken and how did you overcome it?
Mm-hmm. I think if you're out there in the world saying you've never been broken in any way, liar, and thunder fire. I've been broken in the workspace, in personal life, in family. You understand? I have family members who I'm like, should I greet you? Should I not?
Should I just walk away?
Should I just walk away?
Or switch off the lights and walk
yes.
away?
Yes. I've been broken by God, where your spiritual relationship is terrible. You're saying, but you know, God, I can't believe you did that. I honestly can't. And you break your relationship. So people assume maybe being broken is in one space of your life. I think what being broken over time has taught me, and I'll be honest, it's not the worst, you're not the first, you're not the last. Because I think about the problems I had when I was 16, you know, your grades. You're thinking, how could I perform like this? How am I taking this report card? You know what, let me hide it. Should I throw it under the bed? Should I burn it? And that's your biggest problem. And then you grow up and a relationship breaks you and you're thinking, are all men trash?
The hashtag starts.
Yeah, should I ban them? Should I kill them? Men are, then you date again. So I think, okay, so that wasn't the worst thing that could happen. And then maybe you get in a marriage and you're overwhelmed and you say, that is it. This man, I'm going to die. Mm. I can't believe life. And then you heal from that. You're like, okay, so that wasn't the worst thing ever. Then you get into the workspace and you can't deal with your boss. So you're like, okay, this is it. I'm never going to work. That ends and you're like, so that wasn't the worst thing that could happen. So over time, I've learned to compare my problems. When a problem happens, I'm like, ah, but in 95, that was the worst. So this one can't break me. But that's my coping mechanism. It doesn't have to be yours. But I feel like problems are going to show up. So if you already know whether you're yellow, you're black, you're green, you're white, it will show up. Then just live your life. Do you see what I mean? And of course, it took time to come to that conclusion. If you fail today, does that mean you won't show up tomorrow? You will show up. So if you know that, if you know that's not going to change, why are you building a worry tree?
Mm-hmm.
Just live your life.
Cut
down the worry tree. You know either way, even if I'm a perfect wife, I will get problems, right? Mm-hmm. You know that for sure. You're not sure about the good times. You're actually sure the bad times will show up. So just continue to live your life. And if a mistake happens, you say, you know what? Let me forgive myself for that one. It's okay. Let me move on.
Mm-hmm.
Accept it. That's how life is. You can't have ups without downs. How will you appreciate the ups? You must go through the downs. So accept it and move on.
And acceptance means forgiveness.
Oh, well, sometimes for yourself.
Now that's so what about because forgiveness is a part of the journey.
Yes.
Yes, it's a part of the healing.
Yes,
it's also
it is.
A part of you being limitless, because every single time that you hold on to maybe a heart about yourself,
mm-hmm.
you're not happy with what you failed to do yesterday,
yes.
you're lowering how limitless you could become.
Rita, I've learned over time, because I used to be very forgiving of everyone else except myself. Now I feel like I'm very forgiving of myself and not of everyone else. I'm being honest, because that's a part of, you know, being able to share my stories, to be honest. I'm, like I said, with family. I have issues with family that are so deep-rooted that there's some aunties I feel like I will never talk to till I die. But I know at some point we're going to have to heal through it. But I'm saying, for now, I don't want to talk to you. My friend, for now, I don't want to forgive you. Let me hold on to my anger just for like 2 more months. It happens, guys.
Not two more hours.
No, two more months, guys. But I feel like forgiveness as you grow, especially in your limitless journey, forgiveness happens slowly sometimes. Sometimes you're working to forgive yourself for making a mistake, either in trusting Flavia, or in giving Flavia your time, or allowing Flavia to get to your nerves that way.
Mm-hmm.
And as you grow in forgiving yourself, I feel like you may not forgive Flavia, but you may let go of Flavia. So I've learned that I could either forgive or let go. These days I work around those. I say, okay, I've forgiven myself for walking that path. I'm letting you go. When I'm ready, I'll forgive you. But for now, I will let go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we're talking about this, and I feel like we just got into the limitless breakfast before breakfast,
yes.
The actual breakfast. So let's talk about the limitless breakfast.
Please,
when it
yeah.
will be happening for a number of ladies. Keyword here is the ladies.
Yes.
Gentlemen, we'll be
yes.
having yours soon.
Yes. The men were very annoyed when I said it was just ladies, but
we'll get to that, men.
Yes.
Yes, a step at a time. So mm-hmm. when is it happening? Mm-hmm. Is it for free? Do I just walk in?
Mm-hmm.
And is it just going to be breakfast of words, or they'll actually be breakfast to eat?
Mm-hmm. That's very important.
Yeah, because we are really talking. I've had breakfast.
That's very important. It's on the 6th of July. Just going to share this. That's when I was sitting down with the ladies from Pearls for Her. I'm not doing this alone. I approached the ladies from Pearls for Her UG. You can find them on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, just to know what they do. Their work is doing events that are geared towards women. And so since I was doing an event for women, I figured great platform, women working together. And when we're sitting down, we were choosing dates to do it. And I said, no, one of them said 6th July looks perfect. And I said, oh, but that's my anniversary. Who said, we're canceling it? I'm like, no, but it's perfect. It's my relationship anniversary, not my wedding anniversary. But I mean, it's okay. I guess it's a milestone for me, so I can always add more milestones on the day. So it's 6th July. It's going to be at Palliv Spices in Bugolobi because I wanted an intimate space. You know, a place where it's green. Quiet.
Serene.
Yes.
Yeah, serene.
You know, some good air where you can wear your floral dresses and not feel like, but...
Yeah, it's a bit too much.
Yes, a bit too much. So it's a proper breakfast. There'll be lots to eat, lots to drink, and lots to celebrate. And, of course, we're going to have both words and food. So we've designed a limitless card, which, because I don't want this to be just one event and that's it. I want it to be a conversation. So we have a limitless card that you will always pull out when you're stuck and say, but I promised myself on the 6th of July, these many things. How far have I reached? How far have I gone? What have I done for these goals that I promised myself? And then I get to be your accountability partner.
Okay.
Yes. So it's 50,000 for entry, and that's really mainly to cater for the breakfast and any other thing that we'll be giving you. It's not really for me. For me in the future, maybe it will be a profit thing, but for now, I really just want to empower certain ladies. We're expecting a very small number. As I said, I want you to be very intimate. So tickets are already on sale so that, you know, we're able to get that out of the way. So we have Kentaro Handmade Organics, which is at Clisamenti. We have Capital Radio, where I work. And we have the venue itself, Palliv Spices in Bugolobi. So we're catering for whichever direction might be coming from. And I've had people say, me and my friends from school are coming because we finished school and we're stuck. Mm. So I'm bringing my best friends to come. So I have those stories of people who are coming, and I'm excited.
Okay, I personally am excited because, and whoever is watching at this point in time, because you are listening and learning something already just here. Now imagine, how long will it take? How long is this breakfast?
We're doing from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m.
So wow, all those hours for you to tap into how you could become limitless.
Mm-hmm.
So I am seated with a lady who has become limitless, so it's possible.
Mm-hmm.
Now for the gentleman who's not going to be able to come, who's watching right now, or for someone who is not in the country.
Even the ladies who might not be able to make it.
Even it's a limited number
yes.
for those who can be able to buy the ticket now, soon.
Mm-hmm.
What would you tell them?
Okay. Being limitless, even for me who you say I'm limitless today, but I will still continue to remove layers of my life, understand myself, why I make certain mistakes, why I feel a certain way, why I talk to people a certain way, why I'm not achieving what I've set out to achieve. I still have layers to unleash. So don't feel bad that you might be a certain age or might be in a certain place and you're not yet that limitless, or you think limitless is being on TV.
Mm-hmm.
It has nothing to do with that. It's just your life, and have you taken charge, or are you in control of your life? So it takes time and it will never end. So it's limitless as the word.
Yeah.
So don't beat yourself up. But ladies, we only have 60 seats.
60?
Yes.
60.
60.
Six,
so please hurry, get your tickets as early as possible. This week would be great. That way you're not caught up in, but I wanted to.
Payday. Yeah. Some people are waiting for payday, but it's quite affordable. 50,000.
No, but you can wait for payday. It's almost, so it's fine as well. I understand the hassle, my friend.
It is hard. It
yes.
is hard. But that has been our conversation this morning. You can be limitless if you haven't already discovered it. If this morning's conversation with Flavia helped you realize that, wait a minute, I can actually be limitless. Well, We're two ladies on this table, and I can say I am almost limitless. I need to attend the breakfast.
Okay. Come.
That has been our conversation this morning with news anchor, radio personality, and content creator, and limitless lady as well, Mrs. Flavia Chumusime Kabura. Thank you so much for joining
us.
On Morning at NTV. Go on with a limitless journey.
Yes.
Discover, unpack. Do you, as they say.
Yes.
Let's do you.
Do you.
Yeah. Well, Morning at NTV is going to be taking a short break, but we'll be coming right back.
NTV Uganda and Forum for Women in Democracy, Forward, present the Nation Dialogue on the budget under the theme, Financial Year 2019-2020 Budget, Leaving No One Behind. This multi-stakeholders dialogue will provide citizens of Uganda an opportunity